Jacobs. We're honored to have you, especially that you made it happen this time of the day, since we know it was a long day with a lot of meetings. You're Chief Innovation Officer at Mozilla, and we just had a little chat. You've been in the U.S. now for 22 months, and totally new, challenging, not only project, but change of lifestyle, place, living, friends, social network, everything else. And that's a pretty good introduction because we want to find out a little more about the person, Katarina Borschek. So could you share some thoughts with us? How did you get in the industry? How did you start this journey? Because CIO at Mozilla is a pretty interesting position, but it takes the path to get there. Okay. Oh, really? Yeah. Okay. That's quite a journey. And it shows that having a network and, you know, meet people and stick to them and talk to them most likely helps and supports us when doing the next step. Yeah. Yeah. Right. You know, I hear that very often when speaking to people here in the talk and in the studio, and they all say the same thing. They say if there's a challenge which obviously looks too big or too large to go to the next step, definitely you should do it. Take the step and you know, go forward, because you will find out that it's worth it. Because you grow. Thank you. Yeah. You just mentioned being, or you probably even have become a better leader. What do you think is the core skill of tomorrow's leaders? He's not productive. You know what I find interesting? I had Rob Bradley from CNN this morning as a guest, and he answered one question almost exactly like you did. No, let me finish. No, it's not boring at all. What he said was he believes that one of the core strengths of tomorrow's leaders is vulnerability. And I totally buy that, and I totally sign that, and now you said it as well, so I'm allowed to ask the question. If it comes to soft skills, if it comes to social impact of business decisions and flexible work times and whatever, many of those skills seem to be female skills. And now we have the Girls Lounge and the Female Quotient movement next door, and I know you just were on the panel with Shelley. And we all know that we read and talk a lot about more female leaders and CEOs and CMOs, but isn't this, you know, it seems to come together, everything. Because there was Rob. It was not a woman telling me that vulnerability is a core skill of tomorrow's leaders. That's why I'm now allowed to ask the question. Otherwise, it seems like, yeah, come on, you're a woman. Of course you say that. No, I think that's interesting. Okay. Yeah. please. Let's look at Mozilla. What's the biggest challenge project-wise at the moment for you? What is the topic you're dealing or you're spending the most time with? Mozilla and you in your position as a CIO, what are the topics that drive you at the moment? Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Definitely. Yeah. Very interesting project. We'll keep our eyeballs on that. I'll give you my voice. If you could delete one buzzword from this planet that totally kills your nerves, what would that be? I know. Yeah. Of course. Of course. When you turn your smartphone on in the morning, I assume you put it on flight mode or no, you leave it on? Okay. But it's in an arm's reach. You take it to the bedroom and Okay, so when you open your eyes, you grab your phone, what are the three apps to start first to look at? Okay. Okay, and when your blood pressure is up and you realize, damn, I'm off today, I don't have to go to work, what do you do when you're off? What's your passion? Okay.
Yes.
Chill. Very good. Final question. If you look back to your career, was there like one person sticking out that gave you very good advice and you accepted it? best closing keynote ever. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you so much for listening. So we close the first day of New Mexico with Katarina Bosch, and all the best from Mozilla, you in California on your hikes and barbecues. And we keep our eyeballs on you. I'm invited. I will come. Thank you so much. Thanks, guys.